Welcome back everyone to Dental Info. Today we will be learning about the theories of growth, which is a frequently asked question in the exams. In the different theories of growth, we will understand the important points related to genetic theory, sutural theory and cartilaginous theory in detail today in this video. I hope this video makes it easier for you guys to remember points related to growth. So let's get started. Before we start, make sure you subscribe to the channel and click on the bell icon to receive a notification when we release a new video. Now let's start with the theories of growth. First theory is the genetic theory. Second is the sutural theory. Third is the cartilaginous theory. And fourth is the functional matrix theory. Now let's remember the names of scientists and the year in which these theories were proposed. The first theory, which is the genetic theory, was proposed by Brody in the year 1941. Then the next theory, which is the sutural theory, was proposed by Winman and Seeger in the year 1952. The cartilaginous theory was proposed by James Scott in early 1950. And the very important functional matrix theory was proposed by Melvin Moss in 1962. Let's find out an easy way to remember the names of the scientists who proposed the different theories. It is often very difficult to recollect the names of the scientists. We either tend to forget or are unable to recollect the names and the years. Remember this line to memorize the names. The line is, "Grow to be the best, shine with confidence and sparkle from within." This line will not just help you recollect the names of the scientists, but will also motivate you to perform better in your exams. The letter G from the word grow means genetic theory. The letter B from the word best means Brody. The letter S from the word shine means sutural theory. The letter W from the word with means Winman and Seeger. The letter C from the word confidence means cartilaginous theory. The letter S from the word sparkle means Scott. The letter F from the word from means functional matrix theory. And the letter M from the word from means Melvin Moss. Some concepts or hypotheses were also proposed to explain growth, which include the Von Limburg's compromise theory, Hunter and Enlow growth equivalent concept, Petrovic's cybernetic theory. We often wonder why were so many theories introduced. The answer to this is that in 1941, the first theory was introduced by Brody. Over a period of many years, many other theories were introduced after considering the limitations of the previous theory. Understanding the advantages and limitations of each theory is very important for us to master the understanding of craniofacial growth. Now let's start with the genetic theory. As previously mentioned, this theory was proposed by Brody in 1941. Genetic theory is one of the earliest theory. According to this theory, growth is controlled by the genetic factors and is under genetic influence. Brody says that growth is completely pre-planned and that the facial configuration is completely under genetic control. According to this theory, extrinsic factors had no role to play in the process of growth. This theory was more of an assumption and was not proved. There were limitations which were observed related to the genetic theory, which included the following. If the face were under rigid genetic control, it would be possible to predict features of children from cephalograms of patients. This theory was not widely accepted since it observed that genes were not the only factor controlling growth, and this theory did not explain the role of environmental and epigenetic factors. These limitations encouraged scientists to propose the next theory, which is the sutural theory. It is also known as the sutural dominance theory. Now let's understand the significance of sutural theory. Windman and Seacher in the year 1952 suggested that the primary event of proliferation of connective tissue between two bones, suture being the primary condition, causes growth and functional maintenance of bone. Seacher studied the human anatomy and growth in detail. He discovered a possible relation of growth with the sutures and hence suggested that sutures and periosteum are the growth centers which are responsible for the facial growth. So he mainly focused the theory on the sutures and the periosteum. However, there were certain limitations observed in this theory too, which included the following. First was the case showing microcephaly. Secondly, cases showing cleft palate. Also, no growth was seen at the site where sutures were transplanted. These limitations led to the proposal of the next theory, which is the cartilaginous theory. This theory was proposed by James Scott in early 1950. According to Scott, the intrinsic growth controlling factors were not present in the suture but were present primarily in the cartilage and periosteum. Sutures were only acting as secondary sites according to this theory. This led to the basis of the cartilaginous theory. So according to the cartilaginous theory, the intrinsic growth controlling factors were mainly located at two sites, that is the cartilage and the periosteum. After studying the facial growth in detail, it was proposed that the primary growth center of the maxilla lied in the nasal septum. And the primary growth center of the mandible lied in the condylar cartilage. There were many observations made by different other scientists in favor of the cartilaginous theory, which included the following. The transplantation of nasal septal cartilage and epiphyseal cartilage of long bones shows significant growth. Also, that many bones are formed by the endochondral bone formation. Some other observations were made which included that the injuries in the nasal septum in children resulted in deficient growth of face. So let's just summarize the different theories of growth which we have covered today in this video. First was the genetic theory. Second Second was the sutural theory. And third was the cartilaginous theory. The next theory, which is the functional matrix theory, which is an another important topic, will be covered in our next video. Now let's revise what we have learned till now about theories of growth by solving some multiple choice questions. Question 1. Which of the following was the earliest proposed theory of growth? Option A. Functional matrix theory. Option B. Genetic theory. Option C. Cartilaginous theory. Option D. None of the above. Question 2. Who proposed the sutural theory of growth? Option A. James Scott. Option B. Brody. Option C. Winman and Seager. Option D. None of the above. Question 3. In which year was genetic theory proposed? Option A. 1939. Option B. 1952. Option C. 1941. Option D. None of the above. Take your time to answer these questions. You can later verify your answers by checking the description section below. Please like, comment and subscribe to this channel to learn about various dental topics. You can also ask us any other questions or give suggestions in the comment section below.